So here we are again. Captain's Log, Stardate! It's Captain's Log, Stardate, man! Alright, now let's look at the components of a commercial lien. First, you have what's called the allegations. Hold on here. Let me bring this up on my other monitor. Oh, I know. I'll just go to the website where my commercial lien is posted. Oh, that's right. I got it on Facebook. I'll just go to my Facebook. There it is. Hey, you can post your security agreement and your commercial lien on Facebook. All you gotta do is take a screen grab of it and convert it to a JPG. Convert it to a picture and just upload it as a picture. All you gotta do is scan your security agreement and your commercial lien in your computer, scan it and put it on your hard drive. And if you have automatic conversion, you can just change the three letters at the end that say PDF, change them to JPJ, or whatever the picture link is, you know. You all know that stuff, don't you? Most people do, anyway. Or if you need to, just put it on the computer, put it on the screen, and take a screen grab of it. That way you'll have a fresh picture. Now you can take a picture of that and upload your pictures to your Facebook channel. And that's just as good as a public record as any public record of any public record. And it's free. It's free. And if any attorney needs to see your security agreement and your commercial lien, you just give them your Facebook address and give them the name to your photo album where your security agreement and your commercial lien has been stored. This is, in fact, the very reason why Facebook was created, was so that people like us could upload our affidavits in the public, make a public record. And soon, very soon, Facebook will allow us to upload PDF documents. Mark my word, that's coming. So you won't have to convert your affidavits to a picture. You just have direct PDF upload on your Facebook channel. And that's coming. So, Alright. The components of a commercial lien. Allegations. Proof of allegations. Your social security insurance number, your employer identification number, and your treasury direct number. And all those numbers are the same number. It is your social security number. The social security insurance number is written with the two dashes between the numbers. The employer identification number is your same social security number with a dash after the first two numbers. Just one dash. Your treasury direct bond number is your social security number without no dashes at all. Your social security number without no dashes is your U.S. Treasury bond birth certificate application bond access baby number. And any retailer can look at your commercial lien and see that you have listed on your commercial lien the Treasury Direct number. That means the local retailer has the power to go to the Treasury Exchange and exchange your customized paper money for the money that he likes. Most of your retailers like to have that green Federal Reserve debt note money. If you, being the king of your nation, create your own money, you hand it to the retailer, and you tell the retailer, all you got to do is take this to the Treasury Exchange, the currency exchange office, known as the United States Treasury. And have the Treasury convert the currency into the currency that you like. If you give the retailer your own currency, which is probably going to be about 440 volts, that's a little bit too much for the retailer to handle. He can only handle 110 volts. So he's going to go to the currency exchange center known as the U.S. Treasury. And he's going to say, this thing got some power in it. Could you turn down the voltage for me there, regulator there at the Treasury? Can you convert this into 110 volts so that I can be a little bit more happier over here? Woo, this thing got a charge. Woo! That's what you call a hot potato. When you create your own powerful currency and you hand it over to the retailer, he's going to be like, woo, this is a hot potato. Yeah! You tell him, you take that hot potato over to the currency exchange. the International Currency Exchange. And you can get that thing converted into the currency that you like, that you can handle. If you like 110-volt Federal Reserve notes, then you tell the U.S. Treasurer to convert it into 110-volt Federal Reserve notes. And he'll do it for you. Simple as that. Now, if the retailer refuses to take your 440 volts, because he said, woo, this is a hot potato. Oh, that's a little bit too hot for me to handle. Woo! I don't know what to do. What the hell do I do with this? You say, I can't accept that. If he does, you get his agreement on paper. You say, you know, you don't be mean to him, you be nice to him. I'm just using this tone because this is how I'm teaching. Don't go out into the public and be like me, people. I'm just teaching you something. When you go out to the public, you be as nice and as peaceful as you can. We are in a private room having a private teaching. You understand that? So don't be going out in the public, talking to the public like I'm talking to you right now. Or you will soon have a cop on your shoulder and a club on the back of your leg. I'll guarantee you that. Alright. When you go out in the public, you be nice and respectful. And you say, could you please write that on a piece of paper for me? And if they refuse, don't get all mad at them. Just say, if they refuse, say, oh, I respect your opinion. I respect your opinion. Or just say, oh, I respect that. I respect that. That's okay. I respect that. Then you send them an affidavit in the mail and force them to sign for it. But you don't have an attitude when you're writing out your affidavit in the mail. Ah, that sucker! Ah! You be nice and put your nice intentions into your affidavit. Remember, when you use the force speaks for itself. You can stay nice and calm. Remember, a gentle word breaks a bone. Be nice with your intentions when you're writing out your affidavits. Otherwise, if you have an attitude while you're writing your affidavits, Mother Nature is watching you, and she's going to give you a hard time and teach you a lesson. If you remain calm, collect, and composed, and your intentions are all good and well, all you're thinking is, okay, I need to do this because this gives me the power to hire a mercenary. And he'll come in with a gun. And he'll point it at the retailer and say, hey, why do you keep refusing people's custom money? Why do you keep refusing other people's money? And now the retailer is going to have to go, uh-oh, I had better learn to take this money myself to the currency exchange. And believe me, they will learn real quick, because the attorneys at the top of their chain of command know exactly what the name of the game is. Believe me, the local corporate attorney knows how to go to the U.S. Treasury and exchange your customized money and exchange it into Federal Reserve debt notes. And if you don't believe me, you go talk to the local banker and ask him why your mortgage is considered a promissory note. In other words, that mortgage that you sign is a big giant crayon custom money. And they take that promissory note to the U.S. Treasury and exchange it into Federal Reserve debt notes. And then they take those Federal Reserve debt notes and they give them to you and say, now, you go slave a job and pay me back three times as much. Believe me, the corporate attorney knows how to go to the U.S. Treasury and exchange foreign money for Federal Reserve debt notes. When you have a security limit, a security agreement, and a commercial lien in the public record, you are now your own nation. You are the king of your own nation, which is your body. You regulate your body with your thoughts. You rule your body with your thoughts. You're the king. If your body wants to punch someone out, you say to your arm, settle down. Settle down, arm. Settle down. And if you have to, you call upon your other arm to push that other arm down to the side forcefully. Settle down, arm. That's a good arm. Good arm. Good arm. Good arm. There you go. Good arm. That's it. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Just like you're training your dog. Just like you're training your cat, you train your arm to do the same thing, and you train your fist and your tongue to do the same thing. Settle down there, tongue. Settle down. That's a good boy. That's a good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Now, once you put your security agreement in, your commercial lien in the public record, you are now a king. You are an international king walking the earth. You can create your own money. And that's known as foreign money now. You're a foreigner to another nation because you are now your own nation. Although you're living in the United States, you're still your own nation. You are a foreigner. So when you create your own paper money, it's foreign money to the retailer. He says, what's this? Crayon on paper? This ain't money. And you say, well, yes, it is. All you got to do is go to the U.S. Treasury exchange and exchange it. Exchange it for Federal Reserve debt notes. Your attorney knows how to do it. All bank attorneys know how to take your mortgage that you sign for a house. It's called a foreign currency because you put your signature on it. They know that you are your own king. They already know that. And they also know that you don't know that. And they also know that you have not put no king's records in the international record for everybody to see. So they see you as a no-king king. So when you go to the bank and you sign what's called a mortgage, it is a promissory note. That's all it is. It's custom money. It's foreign money. It might have about 20 or 30 pages of it, but it's a big, giant, thick piece of money paper. It's paper money. That bank attorney takes that paper money with your signature on it, and he goes to the Treasury Department, and he exchanges it for Federal Reserve debt notes. You didn't know that, did you? Well, now you do. Welcome to the game, boys and girls. Welcome to the game. Believe me, that retailer has an attorney representing him. And that attorney tells that retailer exactly what he can and can't do. And that attorney has a bank. So the attorney, the leading attorney for every corporation out here in the town, has a banker. And believe me, they talk. They know the game. And that banker knows how to take foreign money to the U.S. Treasury and exchange it for Federal Reserve debt notes. And like I say, they do it every day. Every time someone comes in and asks for a mortgage, all the mortgage company does is say, here's your paper money. It's 20 pages thick. Just put your signature on it. They say, this is paper money you're creating. But they don't tell you that. They don't tell you anything. But they know exactly what they're doing. They're creating a foreign paper money that your signature now creates. And they take that to the U.S. Treasury and exchange it for Federal Reserve debt notes. And they keep the debt notes. And they tell you to go out and work a job and pay them back extra Federal Reserve debt notes, three times the amount with interest. So they get paid four times. All because you don't know how the system operates. But now you do. See what I'm saying? All right. Once you sign yourself out of Prison Planet, you are now your own nation. You can create your own money. You just tell the retailer, give this to your attorney, and have your attorney talk to his banker, and have the banker take it to the U.S. Treasury and exchange it for Federal Reserve debt notes. If they refuse to do that, then you send them an affidavit and send all the copies of everything to the International Military Representative, which is the CID, Criminal Investigation Department of the IRS. The IRS is the U.S. Treasury. So you are sending a report to the main currency exchange center of the United States. In other words, you're telling on them and saying, hey, these guys are not honoring my money. I am my own nation on the earth. I created my own money and they won't accept it. And the U.S. Treasury has a gun. And the retailer knows they have a gun. And so does the retailer's attorney. And so does the bank. So does the bank attorney. And believe me, The U.S. Treasury will force the retailer to give you your products. And they will ensure that your paper currency that you created gets converted into Federal Reserve debt notes. And they'll give the retailer Federal Reserve debt notes, and then they'll be happy. Now, if the retailer keeps refusing person after person after person after person, the U.S. Treasury is going to say, hey, why are you dishonoring the public? And then the retailer is going to have to say, well, damn, you mean to tell me I have to face the belt now? And the U.S. Treasury is going to say, yeah, you get your act together, or we're going to rehab you. And so the retailer is going to have to say, damn, I better get my act together. And I think maybe I need to learn this system too. Shoot, if they can do it, I can do it. Wow! I might need to rehab myself! See what I'm saying? Alright. Well, it's 10 o'clock. Pretty soon we're going to have taps, lights out, maintain silence about the deck, now taps. But before we do, let's welcome the chaplain on the intercom for tonight's prayer. Well, hello, shipmates. This is Reverend Jupadipa, and let us bow our heads in prayer. O thought, the most high thought in my brain, in our brains, guide us through our night of meditation and sleep tonight. Bring joy and peace and comfort and relaxation, wisdom, understanding, and knowledge into our brain while we dwell upon solutions in commerce in private maritime law. In the name of thought, we thank you. Some call you God, some call you Jesus, Allah, Buddha, Muhammad, whatever. We all know that you are just thought, and you reside right here in the third eye that we all have. I praise you, high thought. I praise you. I praise myself, for I am thought with a body. In the name of my thought, amen.